Class Apart, we follow head honchos of corporate India as they try to touch lives of thousands of young children in collaboration with young professionals from Teach for India. A movement of young leaders like Tarun who give up high-profile corporate careers to come and teach these children for 2 years.
After my graduation, I worked for 3 years with Hindustan Unilever, and though the job satisfied me financially and intellectually, I decided to join Teach for India to give something back. It's truly been transformational, not just professionally developing, but personally I think I've been enriched as a person working in such a space and dealing with the challenges. Like, in spite of all the resources that I did not have, I still think as a teacher I can make a difference to these 40 kids.
Today we chat with Anu Aga on why building our next generation is so important. Anu is on the board of Thermax and also that of Teach for India. According to her, it's of utmost importance that learning be fun. Children from a young age should be able to get the most out of education. So we're really talking about our next generation here, and you've been, you know, instilling values in them as we saw in the classroom today. What, according to you, are going to be, you know, key features, key elements or personality traits that we must instill in our next generation so that they can really drive growth as they go into the next
I would say a self-confidence and a sense that anything is possible. They do not limit themselves to the careers which are offered. That a sense of possibility. The world is open up, it's ours, and we can do anything. Love for learning, whatever they, I mean, it shouldn't end with the exams and leaving school or college, but it begins. Right. So love for learning. And in our context, a sense of governance and values, where it's not just what can I grab for myself, but what can I give back. Since I've been the fortunate one, because considering the number of people, children who go to school, and a good school, it's so little, so few, that a sense of obligation that I owe it to society to give back.
Give us a sense of, you know, perhaps a child or children that you've interacted with, you know, through your involvement in TFI, where you felt that it's really made an impact, where it's really touched you, where you've really felt that you've also got back by the end of it, you know, just by seeing that it's helped.
Let me tell you one example where I'm thrilled. In Akanksha, we reach out to slum children who go to municipal schools but don't learn much. And we have centers in Mumbai and Pune. And one of the girls from one of the slums has made it to Teach for India. And I'm in constant touch with her. And I've seen her grow. And she opted to take up a Pune school rather than Mumbai. And for the first time, move away from her family. From a meager salary, she supports her family. And she's so happy. And there's so many things I'm learning from them that really, you don't need money for happiness, but something little more than that. Yeah.
So what's the final vision or the larger aim or the way you'd like to see things, let's say in a few years from now?
I would like every child to have the opportunity to have quality education and not just restricted to the rich who can go to the schools of their choice, but an average poor Indian can get good education, which is what will make or mar his or her life. So I would love to see that happen.
And one of the most important things that you've said today is that education has to be fun, you know, make learning fun. And that's something that you're really enthusiastic about. So leave us with one more example of, you know, when you were young and something you really enjoyed doing as a kid, something that left its mark because, you know, that symbolized to you learning.
I remember the poetry teacher, the English poetry teacher, the passion with which she taught us. For example, a poem called Bridge of Sighs about a prostitute who takes her life. And after, 50 years, it's still in my memory. Or a Hindi poetry teacher who taught us about a postman and how everyone anxiously waits for the postman to bring news. And that has left such a deep impact on me that I can never forget it. Yeah.
Do you remember that poem?
One more unfortunate died from something. Look at her, live in it, you desolate man. Something like that.
Anu, thank you so much for joining us today.
It was
a real pleasure.
Thank you.
Anu Aga with us here on A Class Apart. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you again next week.
Teach for India is seeking outstanding college graduates and young professionals to apply for their 2-year full-time paid fellowship program. The application deadline is the 23rd of January. So if you're interested, log on to www.teachforindia.org.